Hi, it's Karen here from Help with Homework for Kids, and today I'm going to give you lots of bits and pieces to do with grammar, which you may come across in your child's homework, and hopefully this will explain these terms to you. Phrases. Now, phrases are a group of words that need to be in a sentence to make sense. Phrases improve a sentence by adding more information. They always start with a preposition. And phrases don't have a subject or a verb. Some examples of phrases would include under the ocean, beside the highway, over the fence, by the river, and before school. Under, beside, over, by, and before are all prepositions. Adjectival phrases describe a noun in a sentence. The tree beside the railway tracks is dying. Beside the railway tracks tells us where the tree is. It gives more information about the noun. A dog without a collar bit me. Without a collar is the adjectival phrase, and it gives us more information about the dog, which is the noun. Adverbial phrases usually describe a verb in a sentence. They do the same job as an adverb. He swam under the cave and then surfaced. Under the cave is the adverbial phrase, and it describes where he swam, and swam is the verb. The lightning struck the house with great force. With great force is the adverbial phrase, and it tells us how the lightning struck. Struck is the verb. Prepositions position people and objects in both space and time, and they start a phrase. Examples of prepositions include at, about, above, after, across, along, among, around, behind, before, below, beside, between, by, down, during, except, for, in, into, near, of, off, on, over, past, since, through, till, to, towards, under, until, upon, with, and without. Clauses. A clause is a group of words that says something about the subject of the sentence. There are two types of clauses: the principal clause, or the main clause, and a subordinate clause. A principal clause consists of one complete idea. A simple sentence has only one principal clause. Billy made a chocolate milkshake is a simple sentence, and it is an example of a principal clause. A subordinate clause adds more information about the main idea in the principal clause. Subordinate clauses are linked to the principal clause by a conjunction, for example, and, but, or, so, yet, or nor. Or they can be linked by a relative pronoun, who, whom, whose, that, and which. A mechanic is a person who fixes cars. Who fixes cars is a subordinate clause, and it starts with who, which is a relative pronoun. The mechanic won't fix my car until I pay him. Until I pay him is the subordinate clause. But this time it's been joined onto the sentence with a conjunction, until. Conjunctions are used to join subordinate clauses to the principal clause. And here are some examples of them: after, although, an, and, before, because, but, if, once, then, though, therefore, unless, until, where, whenever, when, wherever, while, and whilst. Now, sometimes your child may be asked to find the subject and predicate of a sentence. The subject of a sentence is who or what the sentence is about. So take this sentence for example. The motorbike rider jumped over the barrier. To find the subject, you have to ask who or what jumped We ask that because jumped is the verb. Who or what jumped? And the answer is the motorbike rider. And this is the subject of the sentence. The rest of the words in the sentence are the predicate. The subject consists of a noun group, or a pronoun. Rare albino green tree snakes are found in the rainforest of North Queensland. What is found? Rare albino green tree snakes. So that is the subject of the sentence. The predicate is, are found in the rainforest of North Queensland. Snakes are found in rainforest. What are found? Snakes. Are found in rainforest is the predicate. They are found in northern Queensland. Now, in this example, instead of writing snakes or rare albino green tree snakes, we've put a pronoun in instead. And the pronoun is what is found. So they is the subject. Sometimes the subject is not written, but we understand what it is. For example, short sentences like, come here, the subject is you. It's just been shortened. We could say, you come here, but that isn't what the person has said, so the subject is understood to be you. Make the bed, once again, the subject is you. The predicate of the sentence is the rest of the sentence and it contains the verb. For more great advice, visit our website at helpwithhomeworkforkids.com.